In this video, I'm going to talk about Boolean logic and how the brain system works in Project Spark. So I've got two light bulbs here. The one on the left is the false light bulb. The one over here on the right is the true light bulb. False is going to be red and true is going to be green. So what I have here is I'm going to create a Boolean variable, and I've got one here called true or false, and I'm just going to set it to equal true. Okay, true or false equals true. So when it's true, we have the green light bulb, which is the one, in case you're colorblind, that's the one that's over here I'm standing next to. So that's true. Let me show false real quick. Equals false. So now the other one is on. So this is a Boolean variable, and let me just show you the code for what I was doing here. When true or false equals true, turn on the true bulb, turn off the false bulb, and when it's equal to false, turn off the true bulb and turn on the false bulb. So that shows that true or false, it can only have two different values. It can either be true or it can be false. There's no in between. It's just either true or false. You're only two options there. But I can make it conditional based on something else. So I can use if this rustic lever, let's see if it has power. So if it has power or not, it's going to be either true or false that it has power. That will go to the true or false Boolean and affect light bulbs. So right now it's switched off, so it has no power. When I switch it on, it has power. So notice that you cannot be true and false at the same time. It's one or the other. And that concept is very important in Project Spark because the whole brain system is based on that. We have the when side here. So we have when some condition, here's condition. When some condition, we want to do some sort of action. And it evaluates the entire when side as one statement like that. So if you do something like when A is pressed, then do jump. So that's one statement, and it'll evaluate was the A pressed, and if it's true that the A was pressed, then it'll jump. And if it's false, then it moves down to the next line. So this whole statement is reduced to one true or false statement. And that's a simple example, but if we make something like when A is pressed and right trigger. So because I'm using and looks at everything to the left of it and says, was that true or false, and decides. And then it looks to everything to the right and decides whether that's true or false. If both sides are true, it runs the do side. If neither side are true or only one side are true, then it'll skip that do and it won't run. Okay, so just to show that in action here. So we have when I'm holding down the right trigger, nothing happens. If I press the A button, nothing happens. But when I do both together, that and is true, and the whole when side is true, and therefore we get the do side to run. So that's Boolean logic and Boolean variables. And there are a whole bunch of these built into Project Spark, especially in the movement and combat, that's where most of them are. Movement events. So, for example, when jumping, we could do, let me change this line back to make me jump. So I'll jump with the A button, and then we'll say, when I'm jumping, then hologram myself. So that jumping is a Boolean that says, when the player is jumping, then apply the hologram. And just about any sort of event that you can do has a Boolean associated with it. Swimming, flying, moving, when you're on the ground, or when you're in the air, when you're falling. There's two pages of these. And in combat, there's a couple here, like when you are dead, then the is dead flag is set to true. Is dead Boolean. Some different events. When you've hit, when your attack has hit one of your enemies, this is true. When you get hit by attack, this becomes true briefly. When you're in the process of attacking or shooting or throwing. So there's another two pages of these. Well, there's only blocking on that page. So those are some different ones. And then you can set some others. We'll see what else we can find here. Visible is one. So when you're visible, then the visible flag is set to true. So one thing that we could do is let's do that right trigger again. When right trigger, now in the math folder, when you don't have any other statements, you have toggle. And what toggle means is it changes a Boolean from true to false or from false to true. It just switches the state. It like flips that switch. So I'm going to toggle my visibility when I press the right trigger. Okay, so when I press right trigger, then my character becomes invisible. So that's using a Boolean on the visible. That's one of the built-in ones. And so I could connect that to other things. I've got it connected to whether I'm doing the right trigger, but I could do like in world picker on this switch again. When the rustic lever has power. So there's that same condition I used before for the bulbs, but now I'm making it not control the light bulbs, but control my visibility. So when it has power, it's toggling. It's continuing to toggle because it still has power the whole time. So that's something you need to be careful about. You might want to do when it started to has power, or when it is powered on then visible. So that's an important lesson, that the entire time that this side is true, this is going to run. So when I turned it on, it had power the entire time, and it just continued to toggle me back and forth between visible and invisible. So that's why the character was sort of blinking like that. So that's Boolean variables can store the true false. Just Boolean logic in general, and the way that the brains work, everything on the win side has to be true before the do side will run. One last thing to show is that if you indent, then this line will be evaluated for true, and then it'll go down here and evaluate this one for true. So if we moved the jump down here, and then we did when right trigger there, so it would say when A is being held, and then it'll move down here. This is the same as doing and by indenting. So this line, if the A was not being held down, it would totally skip this line. It won't go to the child line. This is called a child line, unless the parent line is true. So it's a different way to do a compound statement. You see these a lot in some of the default brains. I was looking to see. Yeah, here's one. So when you detect an interactable object in front, then see all these lines are indented. It highlights it yellow, and then it checks to see, are you using the keyboard and mouse? If so, display this icon. If you're using a controller or touch, then display the B button above it. And then when you're detecting an interactable object in front, then it checks to see if the B button is pressed, and then it interacts with it if so. So these are child rules that are only run when you detect something that's interactable. So that's another way to use Boolean logic in Project Spark.